Good morning, students. Come to our class, Biological Science. In the previous class, we have discussed that the cell, its structures and functions. Explain about meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissue. What is meristematic tissue and where it is present? So what is the meristematic tissue? What is its function? The tissue that brings about overall growth and repair is called meristematic tissues. And the present of this tissue, it has divided into three types. Meristematic tissue is divided into three types on the basis where it is present. So generally, the meristematic tissue is present to take its part. At the tip, sides, and between the other tissues, between the layers of other tissues. So the meristematic tissue is present at the tip, sides, between the layers of other tissues. Other tissues. So there are three types of meristematic tissue. One is a apical meristematic tissue. So, apical meristematic tissue. The meristematic tissue that present at the tip that brings the growth in the length of the stem. Okay, na? So the apical meristematic tissue. The meristematic tissue that present at the tip that brings about the growth in the length of the stem. So it gives length of stem. Length of stem. So it is called apical meristematic tissue. The second one is lateral meristematic tissue. So, the tissue that present at the edges in a lateral manner that gives the girth of the stem, that brings the girth of stem, strength of the stem, the girth of stem. So, it gives the girth of the stem, the meristematic tissue which present at the edges. Which is present at the edges gives the girth of the stems. It gives the girth of the stem, strength to the stem. So in a lateral manner it is present. That is lateral meristematic tissue. And third one is intercalary meristematic tissue. So intercalary meristematic tissue. It is very important tissue. All are important. Apical meristematic tissue. A part where the new branches are takes place, new leaves are formed, and where the new buds are coming, the places are known as intercalary meristematic tissues. Okay, intercalary meristematic tissue. A part on the plant body where the new branching takes place. New branching takes place, or new leaves are come out, or buds will come out. That place is called intercalary meristematic tissue. It is also known as cambium. What is that? Intercalary meristematic tissue, also known as cambium. Okay, these are the three types of meristematic tissue that present in the plant tissues. In the plants. Meristematic tissue. Tissue that brings about overall growth and repair is called meristematic tissue. And the presentation of the tissues and the plant body has considered as three types. One is apical meristematic tissue, the tissue that present at the tips. The meristematic tissue that present at the tips that gives the growth in the length of the stem. And the second one is lateral meristematic tissue. This meristematic tissue present at the edges in a lateral manner and gives to the girth of the stem. Third one is intercalary meristematic tissue, the tissue that present at where the new branching is takes place, new leaves are come out and new buds are come out, that is called intercalary meristematic tissue, and it's also known as cambium. Intercalary meristematic tissue is also known as cambium. So, what are the features of the meristematic tissue? The features of cells of meristematic tissue. These cells are, the cells of meristematic tissue are very small and thin. Small and thin. You can how they are look like? They are very small and thin. Okay, they are living cells. Living cells containing a permanent nucleus. Permanent nucleus and abundant cytoplasm is present. Abundant cytoplasm is present. So they are small, the tissues of the cells of the meristematic tissue are small and thin. They are living cells containing a permanent nucleus and abundant cytoplasm. The cells are arranged without intercellular gaps. Okay, now they are compactly arranged. The cells are compactly arranged. That means they are arranged without intercellular spaces. There is no space or the place between the cell to cell. They are compactly arranged. The fourth one is the continuously dividing cells. Continuously dividing cells. Okay, these are the four character tissues. We have started our lesson plant tissues and types of tissues. There are four types of tissues that present in the plants: meristematic tissue, dermal tissue, ground tissue, and vascular tissue. In the previous class, we have discussed that the meristematic tissue and its types of meristematic tissue. Now we are going to discuss another important tissue, that is ground tissue. Another important tissue, dermal tissue. Okay, so dermal tissue, the tissue that forms outer covering of the plant body. Outer covering of the stem. Tissues that forms the outer covering of the stem is called dermal tissue. Okay, outer coverings. It forms outer coverings. Okay, tissue that forms outer covering of the stem is called dermal tissue. So to observe the dermal tissue, take a rio leaf, fresh rio leaf or the betel leaf, peel it at single stroke and you may get the small whitish peel and observe under the microscope. What are the structures that we have observed here? By observation of the dermal tissue under the microscope, we can say that dermal tissue is consisting of a single layer of tissues. So, single layer of tissues showing the variations and the arrangement of cells, particularly based on their function and location. Okay, na? This is a single layer of cells. It consists single layer of cells and showing variation of cells mainly depend on their location and function. Okay, so the dermal tissue is usually consisting of a single layer of cells and showing the variation of cells on the basis of their location and function. The dermal tissue is categorized into three types. One is epidermis, outermost layer. Mesodermis. Middle layer. Endodermis. Inner layer. So, epidermis, it has classified into three types: epidermis, outer layer, mesodermis, middle layer, and endodermis, that is inner layer. So, if you observe the cells of the dermal tissue, the cells are comparatively thicker than the, they are more thicker than the meristematic tissue. Okay, so meristematic tissue cells are thin wall, but here is thick wall. So the cells of the dermal tissue is more thicker than the meristematic tissue. Okay, na? So the leaves contains the tough coat. In the desert plants, you may notice that more waxy in nature. The leaves are waxy in nature. Is it okay, na? It is more tough. Okay, na? They comparatively thicker than the meristematic tissue. The leaves are tough. Okay, na? So in desert plants, if you observe that one, the leaves are more waxy in nature. Leaves are more waxy in nature. And small tiny holes are present. Okay? So tiny pores are present in the leaves called stomata. Okay, na? In these tissues, the leaves are more waxy in nature and they contain small pores like structures called stomata, and the stomata is guarded by a kidney shaped cells called guard cells. Very important bit. The stomata is in stomata. The stomata is guarded by a kidney shaped cell called guard cells. Okay, the cells are very thick in nature compared with the meristematic tissue. The cells are, the leaves are more waxy. In desert plants especially, the leaves are very waxy in nature and they have a small pores called stomata. The stomata is guarded by a kidney shaped cells called guard cells. Okay, in the roots you may observe the long hair like structures called root hairs. Okay, na? Root hairs also present. Root hairs also present in the dermal tissue. Have you ever observed the thick gum-like structure, the thick gum-like substance that present on the branches of the neem and acacia plants? The plants are able to produce the gums also, gum. Okay, na? So, gums. Once you think about it, the hard gum-like structure are substance that are produced by the bark of the plant. The plants have the ability to store the certain excretory materials or the stored food materials or the secretory materials in a particular places. Okay, na? That is in the form of gums. Okay? We know very well what are the uses of gums. Okay, na? So, the dermal tissue of the cells of the dermal tissue also forms several layers around the stem and it forms the bark bed. Okay? The cells of the dermal tissue forms, you think it's a bark? Okay, now? You think it's a plant, stem? The cells of the dermal tissue form several layers around the plant or the stem. This is the bark. What is that? The bark of the plant. So, the dermal tissue protects the plant from many conditions. So, the dermal tissue helps the plants to prevent the loss of water and also involves in the mechanical damages. Mechanical damages like repairs. Okay? So, and also prevent the invasion by the parasites, pests. Okay? So, the dermal tissue helps the plants the loss of water, to prevent the loss of water and also protect it from the invasion of pests and the parasitic organisms. Okay? And also involves in the mechanical damages. to get to repair. So this is a round, sorry, dermal tissue. Tissue that forms of the coverings. It consists of a single layer of cells. Epidermis, mesodermis, endodermis. Okay, they are more thicker than the meristem. The cells are more thicker than the meristematic tissue. Okay, na? So the cells are arranged very thick. So these are the types. Okay, here stomata is present. The stomata is guarded by kidney shaped cells called guard cells. Stomata is present here. Root hairs also present. Root, the long hair like structures that present in the roots called root hairs. Both stomata and root hairs are helps in the photosynthesis process. So the process also done by the succulent cells of these dermal tissue. Okay, this is about dermal tissue. It forms the bark also, it produces the gums. So this is about dermal tissue. Thank you.